welcome to the Midday Live Show. Go on, meet the crew. You know what we just came to do. No telling who be coming through.
Jazza, Frizz, and Steve. Who styles? Gotta fit the mood. It did been a while. They left the milk. I got a DJ too.
DJ who? DJ Spore Milk on the ones and twos. Catch the show. Watch it. It be on 12 and noon. Ain't nothing like them other shows. They checking for your podcast. On hard, just broadcast. Go screen the live on YouTube.
Brand new. Everything about them. Got a bag too. Had to. Cause now they see the stars when they pass through. Bad news. If you ain't up on this, you can't slide through. Especially when they fine dining, shining, but the time winding.
Heard some crickets making some noises, and I was like, yo, this would be a fire, like house music, like sound in the background. So I just like stooped down and like recorded the crickets.
Right.
I didn't do anything with it. Like, it's like I have so much stuff in the vault that I just haven't done a lot with. Mm. So if there's any producers y'all know that are trying to tap in, I've got like an I don't know, extensive catalog. But really, like, inspiration comes from anywhere. You know, it's just conversations, it's what I saw, like driving to work or driving, you know, to get breakfast. It's anything. Mm-hmm. So that's what keeps me flowing, and I could be writing songs maybe 10-15 a day.
Wow.
There have been times I'm on an airplane and I'm like, I have nothing else to do. I'm not about to pay for this in-flight Wi-Fi. So yeah,
it is expensive.
It is.
Can be, yeah, but you just put in that work 24/7.
Exactly.
Love to hear that. Love to hear an artist that's inspired and ready to go. Stay ready. You ain't got to get ready, right?
Exactly. There you have it.
Nice, nice. Okay, so you said Crush is coming out 312 Day, and you want to pay like homage to where you come from. Where did you grow up?
I grew up in Marquette Park, so on the south side of Chicago.
Yeah. Same, south side. Okay, okay. Okay. Neighborhood? Morgan Park.
Park. Hey, okay,
not far, mm-hmm. like down western.
Yeah. A little ratchet, but you know, it's okay. It was a good school back then, back mm-hmm. in the day.
What about so. Now? Can we say anything about now?
It's a questionable.
Questionable.
Yeah,
love
it's questionable.
It. So good. We're reading things. Should have been a lawyer.
Nah.
Nah. Mm-hmm. Why not?
I don't really like arguing.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Mm. I would rather not argue with someone.
But what if you just get in there, state the case, and then, you know, they can't argue. Like, you're that good.
They're speechless.
You don't want to argue?
Not really. I mean...
I ain't gonna lie. Sometimes I do stuff on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on, like, who I'm arguing with.
What's your favorite TV show?
Oh, that's a loaded question.
Trash! It's not good! Sorry.
Oh, yeah. I will defend my favorite characters, my favorite TV shows, movies. Mm. I will defend that all day. My favorite game, you know, I don't play like The Sims.
Yeah.
Don't say nothing bad about that game because it's going to be a problem.
Well, he seems real interested in getting started with discussion.
Let's simmer down. It's International Women's Day.
It is.
I'm right, remember?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. 12 hours.
12 hours. Mm-hmm. It sounds to me like he's ready to go. Ready to... We'll have some discourse if you'd like. You know what I'm saying?
Let's do it.
Discussion number one would have to be, what TV show had the best intro song? Now, I can't take the lead on this. It's not my question. So, DJ Spoiled Milk, could you describe how we're going to list it? Is it going to be a list? Is it going to be top three? Are we going 90s versus 2000s?
Honestly, it may be hard to do, but you got to just choose one.
Just choose one?
Yeah,
that's impossible.
Some of us need to get canceled. Some of us need to, you know what I'm saying? Someone's going to be upset. One TV show song.
I got like six.
Pick one.
Pick one?
That's it. That's all for real.
Ooh.
Pick one.
And it's got to be your favorite one. Like every time you heard it, because back then you didn't have like, you know, TiVo back then or streaming. It was like, all right, 6:30. TV's on, It's on. You either watch it or you're not, right?
Right. And you hear that intro song come on, you got mm-hmm. about 30 more seconds and do what you're doing, right?
Before you gotta sit your tail down.
Come on, man. Mm-hmm. You got your snacks, you're trying to get them together. You better hurry up.
You better hurry up.
The chips and the cookies.
I used to get so mad when I missed the beginning. Like, damn, man, I missed the beginning.
Especially with the this might be mine, the Proud Family.
Okay.
When you see that intro,
that was epic,
to learn
though.
Who's on that episode during the intro.
Yeah.
Come on.
See?
Don't play with that.
That's how the same way we cater with our flyers, you know what I'm saying? That's who you know's next on the Midday Live Show, episode 15, right? So did you go right all in and going all in? If you got all the chips, all in on Proud Family, that's going to be, it's an epic production, by the way.
Yes.
Woo.
I'm saying it.
He's saying it.
I'm standing 10 toes down.
That's
now
real.
I do have an honorable mention.
No. I want to hear. No, what? You said one. Okay. You said one, right?
Right. One. That's
he
it.
Said one. Cut
maybe
him off.
We'll do that after. But your number one is Proud Family.
Okay. All right.
He is so hostile today.
He is. Well, he is.
Well.
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 Traffic.
Traffic sucked today. My God. That's all I'm saying, right?
Okay.
Mine was hour 15. I came from the Northwest suburbs today. So, Jesus.
I took the train.
I took the blue line too, like an idiot.
It was nice. Yeah,
it was lovely. I bet it was.
It was lovely. Thank
lovely. Because at least she gets to park right here at the station, you know.
And boom.
I'm over here.
It must be nice.
It was. Okay, so anyway, Jason, favorite TV theme song?
Please.
You know, I'm glad I've had a few moments to think about it.
Okay.
I think I'm going to go. At first, I was thinking, like, what have I watched recently?
Yeah.
But then those didn't go as hard as the ones in, like, the 90s or the
1000s. Yep.
I had to default to, like, Moesha.
Oh.
To the...
That's big.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Yeah, mic drop.
There you go.
Yeah.
I don't know, Jazz.
I don't know if it's better than the Proud Family. Okay.
It's coming down to you and me. All right, me.
Same genre.
It came down to two. And you're going to be surprised, though, because, you know, my age is going to show two, but like it came down to two. But I'll give you one.
Okay.
Anytime I heard this, and it had to have been season six, the intro to season six was like a smooth jazzy intro.
Sister.
And at the end, Raven Simone gave you the little hand thing in her teal outfit.
Oh.
The Cosby Show, season 6, that smooth jazz. Every time I heard that,
okay.
It hooked me. It hooked me. I was like, what? And I used to sit down and watch it too. Yeah, it was it. And then honorable mention, you know, Family Matters for me. Big Steve Urkel fan, named Steve to myself, had my Urkel moments, but I always thought I was Stefan. But the beginning with the, you know, very similar to Full House almost, if you think about it, right?
Love that theme song.
Right, well, there you go. I'm going all in with Cosby Show season 6.
I'm not sure, Steve, that's going to beat the Proud Family. Go ahead, Jess.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so I want to say my number one. It got to be Arthur.
Oh, yeah. That was number three for me.
Really?
Arthur.
Because every day when you're walking down the street.
It's just, it's one of those theme songs where it's like, it takes you back with a nostalgic feeling. And then you just like feel like happy. Yeah. You can't listen to the Arthur theme song and be like, ugh, I'm about to have a terrible day. Like,
I love that meme though. Love that meme.
Yes.
I'm with that. That's cool.
Oh.
Arthur is number one.
I'm leaning toward Arthur because that was going to be my number three.
But is it better than the Proud Family?
We got to give him point system. All right, let's divvy up the point system. Maybe like one for quality of music. That'll be one section. Another point for
culture,
representing the culture, expressing the culture creatively. Yeah. And then number three can be like, you know how the Proud Family catered to the guest per episode? That's a lot of production work you got to put into it. And back then, the cartoons weren't as easy to make as they are today.
So it's almost as if like the
they got a ding, ding, ding for all three of those, if you think about it.
The intro like coincided with the actual song itself.
Incredible.
It's crazy.
Are we saying that, because we got a clarification here, Breon says that, does it need words? Because the Cosby Show had no lyrics.
Ooh. That's true. No lyrics. It was all smooth jazz.
That is true.
So does it count?
Does it count? Is it just an instrumental?
It's still an intro.
It's still
just
a song.
Still an intro.
Technically, regardless, it's a song.
Yeah.
You know. If you don't like words, then, you know, that's your cup of tea.
Oh, I love me some words. I just can't learn to shut up.
you also said the Boondocks, too, though.
Oh, Boondocks.
That's a good one.
The Boondocks.
That's a good one.
Shit. Yeah. You can.
Honestly, that probably takes that one was heavy.
Wasn't that produced by, like, 900? Who produced that?
I don't know, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, I always thought it was like Method Man.
Method Man. You know, we could do a quick Google search. Did you check our Instagram feed? See if anybody had anything to say on that.
Nobody on IG just yet.
Hmm.
But we got two drinks with the fellas in here, man.
Hey.
Shout out to the homies. I was just on their podcast on Tuesday. Yeah.
It was lit. I'm sure. Lit. Because they be having that cup.
Cameraman. I had the cup in my hand.
Uh-huh.
You know what that means.
That means anything could have been in that cup.
Anything could have been in that
cup. Anything could have been in that cup.
And I'm still upset about the cameraman. If you guys want to, you know what I'm talking about, check out the episode. Mm-hmm. It should be dropping within an hour.
Within an hour? Back-to-back videos.
Prince of Bel-Air.
Yeah, pretty legendary. That's pretty legendary.
I'm not gonna lie, as a DJ, I played that in the clubs today.
That's crazy.
As you should.
Also play the Proud Family too. Like I find a way to mix it in there.
You find a way.
Mm-hmm.
What's the BPM? My demographic.
What's the BPM? Off the you top, you don't.
I don't know. I don't know. But if it's my demographic and I know it's the mid-20s, 30s in there. I'm rocking it.
They're going to catch that.
It's going to be when everybody's drunk, right?
Yeah.
We're hitting with some of the karaoke songs that everybody's singing their hearts out to.
Well, that helps.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The same song.
With the Proud Family. Everybody goes crazy.
That's a gem, DJs, if you want to know a little quick thing. I learned quickly because I got started in strip club DJing back in 2018. And doing that, I had to make sure not only did I please the entertainer on stage, the dancer, that they liked the song, but I also had to get the people involved with it too.
Yeah.
And one great trick I learned early meeting Sean Mack, and I'm sure you picked it up on your own, but getting them to sing song with it, he said, catch a song that's real catchy with it and have people to sing along with you. Mm-hmm. You're getting them in a trance, you're getting them close, because then you can just hard switch from one to the other, and you got people going. It's a whole vibe.
Shout out
big
to
gems.
Sean Mack,
big shout out to Sean Mack.
Shout out, because he definitely has some gems in there.
Fun fact with Sean Mack, shout out. Here we go. A little funny story about me, because you know I can't shut up. But for Summer Jam, you know, my laptop crapped out, right? Wow. I texted him because I knew he was DJing that day, and I was the opener. He didn't have to be until mid-show. Hey, Sean, I know you got another MacBook. Can I borrow your laptop? He said, I'll be there in 5 minutes. I'm finding parking.
Wow.
He let me use his laptop for Summer Jam. There you go. Fun fact.
Wow.
Boom.
Shout out to my mentor.
Let's go. To Sean Mack.
Killed it.
Save the day.
Save the day. Superman. Save the day.
Wow.
Nice. Okay. Now we got to get back to the real reason that we're here. Jason Ivey, across from me right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I think we should play Rapid Fire.
Let's do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Steve, can you do that, run that errand for me?
Absolutely. I'll be right back.
Thank you. Okay, so I'm going to start it off real easy.
Okay.
Dogs or cats?
Dogs.
First of all,
great
there's
answer.
One rule.
Mm-hmm.
First thing that comes to mind, you got to let it ride. Okay? Yeah. This here is a safe place. Safe place.
Okay.
All right, go for it.
Dogs, okay.
Right?
Dogs, yeah.
So we said dogs. Okay, so most prized possession?
My phone, because it contains all my songs.
Mm.
Yep. You lost too many notebooks? You learned your lesson?
Yeah. I literally lost one yesterday.
Oh, wow.
And I'm not the type of person to lose anything, but I had an important meeting, logged onto the meeting. The person was running late, so I was like, I got time, but I could not find my notebook. Still can't find it.
I just,
digital is better.
Well, they say that when you're not looking for something, it pops up magically. So just stop looking for it.
Okay.
It'll pop up.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's
okay.
Anxiety for me.
It is. You just got to trust it, though.
Yeah.
Describe your style in one word.
Black Ivy.
Ooh.
Yeah. I guess that's two words.
That's okay.
But
wow,
also
let
comfortable.
It ride. Let it ride.
Nice. Okay. If you could trade places with one person for a day, who would that be?
Be my dog.
Really?
Yeah, because he gets to do whatever he wants. He does.
You know what? I'm not gonna lie, I've always had moments like, man, I wonder what my dog is thinking of.
Yeah.
And I'm also wondering what he does when no one's at home. You know what I'm saying?
That's real.
Yeah.
And it's also the dogs are, I think cats do it sometimes too, but they'll like and you're like, wow, what's going on with your life?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You're
stressed?
You're
stressed?
Why are you sighing?
Yeah. Right.
Must be nice to just chill all day.
You upset about something?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You didn't get your favorite treat yet?
Long day at work.
Long day. Okay. What was your first job, speaking of work?
I was an actor. So I was about three when I started acting. You know, I was doing like Disney magazines.
Wow.
And I did that until about 9 years old.
Nice.
Quite the first job.
Mm-hmm.
Impressive.
Long days. Long
oh, I
days.
Bet. Yeah.
Wow.
But like, you know, you kind of get to see some of the bigger stars. And that was pretty cool. Yeah.
Cool.
Nice. Okay. We're going to have to get more stories on that at a later date.
Yeah.
Because I'm a very much a Disney person. Yeah. Name one guilty pleasure.
You know, I don't know. I don't really have guilt.
No,
guilt.
Proud.
It's hard to
no regrets.
Yeah, no regrets. I don't know.
Okay.
Maybe ice cream.
What flavor?
Honestly, anything new. Like I just tried a hot toddy at Jenny's, and it has like actual bourbon in it, and it's got like cayenne pepper, like honey, lemon.
Mm.
Like literally, it's a hot toddy but frozen. And I was like, so I just try new
that.
Things, and I'll definitely have like a full freezer stocked.
Okay.
I would
full freezer.
That.
Yeah. That sounds good.
Mm-hmm. I would
passing it
that.
To you.
You mentioned that you got a chance to meet some of the higher celebrities. Mm-hmm. What celebrity would you go out to dinner with for the day? Or just hang out with? It doesn't even have to be dinner. Just hang out with.
That's hard. Solange.
Oh.
Great answer.
I wonder what she does in the day.
Now, with this, would you get in an elevator with her?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm just curious,
you
know, I just want to know. And then are you standing next to her and still conversating, or are you going to stop talking and wait until you guys get to the level that you guys are going to? And then start, I would be a little nervous. Like
I'm talking.
Hey, I heard you had hands in here, you know, so just
as long as you don't say nothing crazy to her.
Exactly. Yeah. Okay.
You should be good.
I'm not talking out the side of my neck. So
right.
We'll be
right.
Just,
hey,
I'll be like, know? Hey, I got a future slot open. And, you know, maybe that might be the wrong thing to say, but
I believe that shooters got to shoot.
You got
the opportunity. Say it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're kicking it with them, exactly. I would say let's go to the studio and kick it. Then.
Yeah.
That's for real.
That's
yeah.
True. Might come out with like 4 songs.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see here. Who do you text the most?
Probably my partner.
Nice.
Yeah, all day.
Nice.
Pretty much.
I'm with it.
Oh, sweet. I love that.
What is your go-to karaoke song?
Ooh, it was always Miguel's, what the heck is it called? Adorn.
Mm. Yes, I love that song.
Nice.
It's such a challenging song, but like, I'll be nailing it. Like,
yeah.
Or like Rihanna's Stay.
So you're like a full-blown professional, right? Mm-hmm. When you're in these karaoke settings, are you there as the rest of the drunk people there? Or are you like real life performing this song right now?
Honestly, I think I'm real life performing the song. And it's less pressure because most times people are not going to recognize me. So I'm just like, I'm going to hop on stage. This is a chance to like try something new. And like people are drunk. They don't really care anyway. Yeah. And then even if I like mess up half the lyrics, I get off stage and they're like, oh my God, that was
You're
great.
So good.
But if I mess up half the lyrics on stage at like House of Blues, then they're going to be like, what are you doing here?
Right. I feel that.
You know?
I feel that.
If I could sing too, I would do like the full on performance. Yeah. I mean, I do it anyway. But yeah, I can't say the vocals are there. They're not on Jason Ivey's level at all.
I'm going to say, let's hear it.
Let's do it.
Are you trying to sing?
Karaoke, no. Baby. So as
karaoke.
DJ,
okay.
As a DJ, when I did have people come through who could sing, I used to like line them up towards the end of the night. Like, you're closing my karaoke out tonight type thing. But it was just always a different type of energy in that room.
Mm.
The rest of us are drunk and just trying to have fun. But when we have the opportunity to just listen to like a voice that actually carries some weight behind it, we were like, yo. This little vodka cranberry is hitting different.
Yeah.
It's all vibrations.
All vibrations. If you could bring back any fashion trend, which one would it be?
Maybe like the big t-shirts.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like that's coming back anyway because people are doing like the baggy pants with the cargos. I feel like the big t-shirts is next.
Mm-hmm.
They're
I'm
doing like
that.
The Kim Possible She-Go.
That's crazy. I remember that cartoon.
Yeah,
that's funny.
I'm with that. All right, we're talking Chicago. You are from Marquette, correct? Who has the best pizza in Chicago?
You know, I'm gonna sound really bad, like a bad Chicagoan, because I'll be going to Pizza Hut sometimes.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna hold you. If I got friends in town, I'll take them to like Pequod's to show them deep dish.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But like, if it's just something quick, I'm getting a little personal pan Pizza Hut for $5.
You know, the personal pans, they hit too, you know. I'm from the days where you used to book it club. You know, remember the book it club?
Yeah, actually,
yeah. Yeah, you read X amount of books, you get yourself a little personal pan pizza.
That's true.
That was decent because they would cook it Detroit style. Ooh. You know, like most pan pizzas are. But hey, pizza's pizza or is pizza something else?
Pizza is pizza.
Thank you.
Pizza.
Little Caesars.
No, that's too far. Not Little Caesars. Mm-mm.
Yeah, it's not.
It's not hidden.
It's not
like Domino's. It's like,
really?
Yeah, it's gone really downhill.
So
yeah.
When they were $5, were they hidden? I just want to know.
Well, now
there's
six.
And
now they're $6 each.
Oh, no. $6 is too much. I refuse to buy a $6 pizza.
But I'll get them for, like, staff, you know what I'm saying? For, like, good old manager will do that for the staff.
Yeah. Yeah, pizza party.
Yeah. Judging.
Yeah.
You come up here with some Little Caesars, I'm judging.
Don't you worry.
Yeah. I guess we got to talk about chicken then. What we got out there? J&J's, Sharks, Harold's, Uncle Remus.
Yep. That's pretty much the Bob's.
Four standard.
Yeah. Which one is it? The people want to know.
Okay. So being in Marquette Park, I feel like on 67th, it would always be rotating. Like it would be a Sharks 1 year, be a J&J's the next year.
Okay.
Bob's 2 summers from now. And and then it might like switch back to a JJ. So you never know. Like you walk down the street, and you're like, what was that? Just the Sharks? Like, I feel like I've tried all of them. They're all about the same. About the same. At least JJ's and Sharks to me are the same.
Okay.
Those are the same. I've never tried Uncle Remus.
Me either.
Same. I did.
So, like last year.
All right.
I did one time. I wasn't a fan. Yeah, exactly. It wasn't good to me.
I just like the sauce on the fries.
Is it a situation where the sauce can really make the chicken better?
Yes.
Yes. Definitely. Always. Yes. Sauce is key.
Uncle Remus has their own sauce?
Yes.
Oh.
Something like that, right?
What is it called? Sauce.
It's I don't know what it's called. I guess it's their version of mild sauce, but it's like a little sweeter.
Okay.
But also the chicken matters. Right.
Right. No, for real.
Yeah.
Chicken does matter. If your skin is not crispy, flaky,
yeah, please.
The texture, gotta be there.
The texture needs pass. To be there. If your chicken is soggy, that is just not okay for me.
Flaky and crispy.
Yeah. Flaky and crispy. Right. Absolutely. You gotta hear it. You gotta hear it.
You
hear
those like those do-it-yourself TikTok videos when the audio is like it's
when they shell
too
the
much.
Yeah, and they scrape it or something.
Mm-hmm. Like
yeah,
all the way.
Yeah. A little ASMR.
You wanna hear it?
You gotta hear it.
For real. Yeah.
Real.
You want to jump in there, Steve?
You got it. I mean, if you were to wear a warning label, what would that warning label say?
You know, honestly, it might be like, might inadvertently steal your girl.
Because
I'm never trying to.
Okay.
And also, it'd be like, I do not work here. Like,
oh,
I feel like I've got that like, very approachable style where people come to me and, like,
I do
any
not work.
Store, any store that I'm in, they'll be like, can
you help me?
Can you help me? Aisle 16? Like, shut up.
I need some help.
I need some help.
I don't know what we're doing here. But yeah, I've been in like plenty of scenarios where I get looks. And then I get looks from like the dude. And he's like, what are you? Wearing? And I'm like, I'm not even looking.
Yeah, bro.
I'm literally just.
Interesting.
Very interesting.
Very interesting.
That's the first time we heard that one.
Well, you heard it here first. It's not his intention. Okay.
Right.
Another exclusive.
Exactly.
If you were to be offered an expensive gift, like a $1.2 million gift or something homemade from the heart, what would you choose?
I'm prone to say the expensive gift, but I know I love something homemade from the heart. Like something functional I can use every day.
Okay, good.
Give me like a nice wallet that I can use for the rest of the year.
Right. Not like macaroni art. No.
I'm sorry.
That's like, from the heart. Yeah.
You know, I've had like wallets made. You know, it's like I made this wallet. You go.
Nice.
That is awesome. Make me a wallet wherever you are out there.
Yeah. And like they made it out of tape and like a Ziploc. I was like, this is like the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Nice.
Oh, is it one of those duct tape wallets you used to make back in high school?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, nice. I remember those too.
Until I left the wallet in my jeans, washed them.
Oh, and they got stuck.
Oh, man.
There goes your pocket.
Yikes.
It was a wrap. Yeah.
Oh, man. That's crazy. So if you could have a superpower, what superpower would you choose?
I would say win anything.
Ooh.
That's amazing. Nice. I never thought of it like that. I'm thinking the X-Men. That's pretty basic. This guy's like, I'm going to win.
Yes.
That's
like,
awesome.
That's unlimited power. That's, you know what I'm saying? You put in a job application. You know, you won. You go to the lottery. You won.
One.
Nice.
You play a basketball game.
You won. You just show up and like, I'm him.
Literally.
Do you really want to do this right now? Just give me the
rock. Let's go.
That's smart. Wow.
Nah, that's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
Well, that's amazing. I'm just speechless. I'm like, that's great.
Wow,
that's
great.
That's impressive.
Impressive. Yeah. What is your most used emoji at the moment?
Okay, it's between the sparkle, like the three little like.
I love that emoji.
It's great, right?
Yes, it's like, just little.
Like make a wish. That one.
Foundation. What?
Why does it make a wish?
I just think of like, oh, my wish come true, and you got the little two fingers with the sparkles.
Definitely have used that combination. Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Never thought about it like that.
Yeah.
Well, what does it mean to you?
It's just like magical.
Yeah.
You know, just like.
Or making people's wishes come true, where they're like, "Thank you," and you're like, "You're welcome." Sparkle.
Oh, okay. Yes. Be like, "I'm him again. I'm him. I'm him." Is this a theme? This is a theme.
Yes. You need the emoji twice. And what, between the word him.
He mentioned another emoji. What would that second one be?
It would be the like the content. content face where it's just like everything's good. Like, I can't even describe
the meh face. It's like a straight line, not a smile, right?
No. It's like it's content. Like, there's like a slight smile. The eyes are closed. And it's like,
oh yeah, I know. Content. What you're talking about.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Where it's like I just got home chilling for the day. Boom.
Chilling.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. That's what's up. And if you could hang out with any cartoon character, could you name that cartoon character for us?
Maybe BoJack
Horseman. Ah.
Interesting. But I don't want him to, like, you know.
What?
Depress me. I don't want to walk away feeling like, why did I make this choice?
Oh, kind of my gosh. Right? He's like, Sonic the Hedgehog. No. Shadow. Okay. Crazy. All right.
Yeah, man. If you just tapping into the Midday Live show, we are kicking it with Jason Ivey, learning a little bit about him, man. We want to learn about you as an artist as well. So if this is the first time someone is in tune with Jason Ivey, who are you?
So I am an alternative R&B singer. I write all my own songs, but I think I might step out of my comfort zone and let some other people write for me at some point in the future. I produce like a third of my work. But yeah, alternative R&B, neo soul, those are kind of my genres.
Okay.
I'm stepping into the like rock world as well, maybe into the house world as well.
Nice.
Just because I want some more dancey tracks. Like, I'm hearing what Jungle, groups like Jungle is doing, and I'm like, yeah, that's a vibe all the time. Every song they put out is like a vibe, and that's kind of what I want myself to be, but still have that message and still have that like homage to Chicago.
Always.
I've had some decent success, last year. What's the Word named me Artist to Watch.
Oh yeah, very nice. We like that. Congrats. Shout out to What's the Word. Nice. Yeah.
Nick Cannon named me Chicago Speaker Superstar.
Hey.
Shout out to Nick Cannon, man.
Yeah. House of Blues is huge, man.
I didn't get to shake his hand, but we fist bumped. I was like, it was like in the moment where you're like, which one do you do?
No, yeah.
We did the fist bump, and I was like, well.
When in doubt, fist bump is what you're saying? Yeah. Okay, when in doubt, fist bump. Well, that's great to hear, man. We'd love to hear that, especially the exclusives here on the Midday Live Show.
Exactly. Yeah. We can't wait to hear Crush on 312 Day. And definitely I wanted to ask if you have any just advice for any up-and-coming artists just trying to really start taking their career seriously.
I would say reach out to me. I'm not the type of person to gatekeep. I'm not the type of person to like withhold. If I have a gem or like a good piece of advice, I'm gonna definitely share it. Because I've experienced those scenarios and those environments where I'm asking for help and someone's like, oh yeah, I'll definitely help you, and then they don't like the avatar when like the world needed them the most, and it's just like, come on,
the content emoji, peace emoji,
whatever you need. Whatever you need, I'm here, just text me.
And then you're like, man, I've been just texting you for like a good month or two.
Is this even your number, bro?
That's what I'm saying. And I'm like, yeah, the text is still blue, so like it's gotta be, but yeah, like reach out to me and I'll try to point you in the best direction that I can for collaborations, for studio time, for whatever, just general advice. And then I guess generally just don't give up. Typically as artists, we're our own biggest critics and also our own biggest supporters, but the balance is skewed a little bit. It's usually like, oh, I'm not good enough, or this isn't it, maintain that balance where you're consistently aiming for improvement and you're also pretty confident still, I would say.
Nice.
Yeah,
beautiful.
Nice. We have a comment here by Mr. On My Grind. He wants to know if he can get a little sample of the vocals while we're here. Ooh. It's up to you.
Ooh.
You can let it
so
ride.
You put me on the spot.
Yeah, hold on. I haven't even had any water today. I guess I could sing something.
I'm
trying to think of like a good good vocal sample.
And you're comfortable with singing on the spot, right? No big deal.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You know what? Actually, historically, I've never been comfortable singing on the spot.
Oh, all right.
But since this person asked so nicely,
that's but not I've been just in, any in person.
Where, like, I'm in a meeting with like a person from like a label or from like a tour company.
Yeah.
Sing. I'm like, no.
Yeah,
we're having lunch. I just took a bite of this burger. I can't sing right now.
No,
right.
Did you ever see that Vince Staples thing when they're like, he gets he's trying to complain and not really complain, but he has the right. He's doing an interview and they're like, hey, we know you're here to promote your album and you got these 16 bars you're trying to eat off of. Why don't you spit us a hot freestyle real quick, you know? That's some weird stuff. I get it. I get his perspective. You have an art. You have something you're offering. I get it. I get it. But are you comfortable? Get to it. We're here for you.
This is going to be a Frank Ocean song.
Frank Ocean.
So, what do you think my brain is made for? Is it just a container for the mind? This great gray matter. Really
okay.
Really,
very smooth.
Since he replied, what is your woman? Is she just a container for the child? That soft pink matter, cotton candy, Majin Buu. Ooh, close my eyes and fall into you.
Cut it off. No more.
It's like we have women listening. We have the ladies listening. We got to be careful. All right.
That was
amazing. Wow.
And again, I just took a sip of the water.
That's heavy for real.
No prep. That's amazing.
That's the plug. Stream his music.
Yeah, exactly.
Cut it off. Nothing else for free.
Exactly.
That's really good.
That's a valid point. Yeah. Got to cut it.
Jason Ivey on every platform.
Okay.
Like Jess already mentioned, I'm dropping on 312-day crush. That you can hear the falsetto there. I definitely had one before I went to the studio that day.
That's a range though, I'm just saying. Yeah. That falsetto's hard, man. Very difficult to do.
It is.
Yeah.
And I wasn't sure I was gonna get
there. But stop.
Please.
Right. You're the man. You got this. You got this.
Yeah, man. We definitely appreciate your time coming through, man. We learned a lot.
Definitely did.
Yeah. Throw the social out there one more time.
That's the Jason Ivey everywhere.
Awesome. Drop some emojis, guys. If you're listening, if you love to hear the music and you love the Midday Live Show, dishing out videos every Friday, hit the subscribe button. We're going to take a short break, probably about 2-minute break, and then don't move a muscle. We got Young G coming up next.
time.
Yep. Oh.
Well, everybody gets associated and situated. I'm going to take a solo layout real quick. Remind everybody to hit the like button, hit subscribe. We got new videos dishing out every week, new content every week as well. Follow us on Instagram at the Midday Live Show. It's good. I went solo, started holding it down while everyone's taking care of things. We're in the middle of transition, guys. But if you saw the intro I played, it was Creative Business 101. So I'm thinking while everybody gets situated, I dropped some gems. A little bit about the music industry. Last time we did it, we was on dub plates. Just want to remind everybody to start getting 8-count intros. Also mentioning the DJs that are local in the area. DJ Spoil Milk, mixing it up. You could shout out myself. Hey, what up, Chicago? It's DJ Steve Styles. Or be like, yo, got a new track. We got Jamal Smalls, you know what I'm saying? Shout out the DJs. Leave an 8-count bar in the beginning of the song. So the DJ not only knows how to mix it in, throw him the BPM. Be ahead. Be an artist that knows their craft, that stands out from the rest. Don't be one of these John Does, you know, and they'd be like, oh, I could rap. Homie, I could rap too. Check me out. I used to rap about 15 years ago, so we know. But I guess. Low key, high key. Steve got a lot of things. But just a friendly reminder, dub plates, very cool thing. Dropping gems every show. Only on the Midday Live Show. We're going to bring it back to the group. You guys ready? We're going to bring it back full screen. Welcome back.
Hey.
That's how they hit it. Sure.
Uh-oh. Who we got in the room? Jazz?
Well, we know.
I was like, well, we know.
We know.
He's no stranger to the Midday Live Show. Yeah. Last time he was here was December, I think, 2022.
Yeah. Goodness.
Yeah.
What a good month. Yeah. What a great month.
Right? Mm-hmm.
That was huge. And then Jingle Ball.
Yeah.
Hometown Hero.
Jingle Ball. Yeah.
Article.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
That was fun. But no, we're not talking about me, even though it's Women's Day. We're going to get to that later.
Month, I guess.
Shout out to the women in
the
room.
Man. Hell yeah.
Thank you.
Give a clap.
That's right. Big shout out to the women. We love the ladies. Love the ladies.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I do have to introduce a man. I'm sorry. It's okay. It's fine. So he goes by the name of Real Young G. From Joliet, just like DJ Spoil Milk.
Joliet. DJ Town, you know.
Yeah.
No, the town, he says, right? The town?
The town.
Okay. Yeah. Artist, actor, entertainer, all jack of trades, pretty much. It's Real Young G on the Midday Live Show. Welcome back.
Mr. I know everybody backstage.
Okay.
I swear.
Okay.
Thank y'all for having me, man. I appreciate y'all. Y'all like feeling for real.
Oh, we love it, man. He's been with us since the jump, and we want to thank you for showing up here in person on a crappy, rainy day where traffic is just whooping our ass.
Man, quick. I was doing the dash, getting up. I can't get no more tickets, but for the midday, I'm going to get some more tickets.
Let's go. Definitely worth the ticket. You know, a whole meal ticket, guys, but time will tell. Welcome.
You, appreciate it. Hell yeah. Glad to be here.
So what's new on the agenda? What are you promoting? What's on the block?
Man, right now we just dropped Emotionally Unstable. The project just dropped Valentine's Day, really.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's kind of just been dropping video after video. I call it YGN Fridays. Every Friday I drop a video. If it's either every Friday, every 2 weeks I drop a video off the project.
Nice.
And I feel like we live in a day and age where it's content. Content is key. And they say, like, remember they say cash is king? Content is king.
Yeah.
So you gotta just switch it up, man. I'm dropping music videos, like, you know, some of these people dropping blogs. So
I feel you.
I'm just trying to build the brand, build the label, and just, you know what I'm saying, take things to a whole new level.
Can we dive in on that real quick? And just the word consistency is coming to mind too.
Yeah.
And I know this from being inconsistent myself too.
Yeah.
But say you got 30 days in a month, for example, right?
Yeah.
And in those 30 days, you have 30 opportunities to throw your content out there so someone can get to know you.
Yeah.
Now imagine there's 12 months in a year and you hit almost 30 days every month.
Yeah.
I don't know. Let's do the math. What's 12 times 30? Somebody out there, help us out.
Somebody help us out.
It's not going to be me.
Cool. We'll say, I'm going to say like over 300, right? Yeah, I'm going to say something like over 300. That's over 300 different opportunities, you know, 365 plus give or take the days, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That you have to get your name out there. Imagine if you do that for a year straight. Somebody's going to know who you are.
Yeah.
Some label rep, some A&R, some person from some ad place is going to be interested in trying to promote you.
Real life.
Yeah, you'd be surprised.
Yeah.
How do you stay consistent?
Basically, man, I say all the time, man, when motivation leaves, discipline has to kick in. Because we can get motivated by anything, right? Mm. And motivation can only last a short period of time. But you got to be disciplined. You got to be dedicated. You got to wake up and tell yourself, I don't feel like doing it, but I got to do it. Because guess what? That day might be the day that I might just get all the way on. That this song might be the song that get me all the way viral. Or this connect might be the connect to take me over to the next level. Mm-hmm. I mean, I feel like some people, they lose motivation because, you know, life, circumstances, and they say life be lifing, which is real, though. Life do be lifing, but you got to have that dedication. You got to have that discipline. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, you just got to wake up and tell yourself, I am going to be great. Like, I wake up every day like nobody know me. And we almost had 1 million followers, but I still wake up like nobody know me. You got to get to it, for sure.
Preaching up in here today. Come on now. So when it comes to, you were talking about earlier, like building the brand and stuff, like what kind of things do you do that you could, like, I wouldn't say teach, but like give other people advice or like tips on how to like build their brand up?
Man, you just gotta, like I said, number one, you gotta put content in. Number two, you gotta believe in yourself. Number three, you gotta network. Networking is your net worth. So the more you network, the many people you know, you never know who could help you along the line. I tell people all the time. I was just talking to my boy, Austin Hood, and we were just talking, like, Michael Jordan didn't win the rings by himself. If you notice, you know what I'm saying? Thanks. He was playing in the game. When he first tried to do it by himself, he couldn't. Mm-mm. It take a real team, people that you can kind of take the weight off your shoulders and trust, because you got to do what you got to do. And you, if you love it and you really dedicated to it, you're going to sit here and try to be the best at it. So network with people. Stay pushing out content. Nowadays, we live in an age where stuff moves so quick, right? So you got to learn how to utilize TikTok, utilize YouTube, utilize Instagram, utilize Facebook, utilize Twitter. There's so many options out there that you can put content out, but you got to put it out on all those sites, because everybody don't use everything, but it's somebody on something.
Yeah, that's
you
right.
You see what I'm saying? So that's what you got to realize. It may, and whether you get one follower, two followers, three followers, four, well, some people just see it. They see it. I've been stopped places plenty of times where people's like, bro, I be seeing you. I be like, love. And some for the artists, I got to tap in with the DJs for sure. I can't stress that enough. Y'all got to tap in with the DJs. That's never going to be a lost art. Whether you in the club, whether you out in a certain event, tap in with the DJs. They're going to show you love. You show them love, they show you love back.
I have a better question about that now, whole time. So how would you give advice to an artist to approach a DJ? I feel that sometimes there is a time and place.
It is.
But I want to hear from your perspective.
It is. Number one, I say, you know, build that relationship. You can't reach out on social media because everybody don't see the DMs, right? And especially if you in the mix, let's say we're in the club, I can't really, if I don't really know of you, quote unquote, I'm gonna push you to the side, because at the end of the day, I understand it's like you in the groove, you in the gym, you got what the people want to hear. So hey, the club over with, how the DJ afterwards, because you know they be time and place, the club gotta close eventually,
right?
Hey man, can I get your contact? I feel like he'd be like, for what? You know, because I want to, you know, promote my music. I'm an up-and-coming artist. And even if, you know, you can't give it a spin, I want to get your feedback on it. I want to build. Let's build.
Yeah.
So he tell you, you know what? All right, I like the way you approach me. Here's my number. Here's my email. Send me something. When I get a chance, I'm going to check it out. Mm-hmm. And when they check it out and they reply back to you, like, yo, I like this. This is bumping. We could probably get a campaign going, whatever the case may be. Just build.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So,
That's real.
Real life.
For some of the artists that are out there, you know, trying to talk to a DJ while he's working, aka spinning, aka crowd control, aka the vibe of the entire building, is not the right time.
So,
and, you know, if that DJ comes off as short, disrespectful, don't take it personal. Mm-hmm. Don't take it personal, because he's probably giving you the same answer that the drunk girl requested, you know, Sexy Red 10 times. He played it already.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
He's giving the same message to her too. So
$100 a request. $100
now,
a request.
Now you get that man attention.
That's
what I do.
Just talking,
Man or woman, because there are women DJs out there. Shout out to the women in the world.
Yeah.
But no, that's real. Yeah. That's real. You also spoke on building your brand on multiple platforms. Yeah. Somebody may be on this, but not on this, right?
Correct.
TikTok is trending right now because it may get banned in America next week.
Ooh.
I don't know if y'all knew that.
Yeah, I just saw the news today before coming up here, for sure.
Yeah, so how do you feel about that? Is that a platform that you tapped into? How will you change the way you're moving your campaigns and your branding as an individual? Like, how you feeling about that?
I feel like TikTok, one thing I learned about TikTok is, you know, everybody, you can't go with the trend. When I'm saying that, meaning like, you know, you see artists try to make trendy music and they go viral on TikTok. Mm-hmm. You can't do that. You got to look at it as content, right? Mm-hmm. So, you know, you got to get on. I get on TikTok and I talk real shit. Like, I say real things, like about motivation, or, you know what I'm saying? Steve say, give out tips to the artists.
Oh,
that's going to go more viral than the music.
Mm-hmm.
Because then you got to think about it. You got a million artists, right?
Yeah.
So TikTok is a brand to help drive its content base.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
it goes real fast. So it helps drive an audience to you. Who is this dude? He's talking real stuff. I like it. I'm going to follow him. It's TikTok. I didn't see my stuff go viral just off of me just talking.
Boom.
Right? Not even the music. I'm just keeping it real. You know what I'm saying? And then they'll drive them to my music. Oh, you do music? Oh, you pretty dope. Okay, then. All right. But they have to know your personality.
That's right.
So each platform is used for a specific reason. Like TikTok is content creation. Now, if it gets banned, it's just another way to go around it, far as you got to find different avenues, different sites. It's always new technology being uploaded, right?
That's
it's
right.
Always new things, yeah, always that new. People want to test and beta.
That's right.
And once the wave, you got to be the first to do it. It's like crypto, right? Mm. When people didn't know much about crypto, and people that invested in Bitcoin are millionaires right now. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When stuff is already trending, it's already too late.
It is, like, even right now, Bitcoin, it's on its way to 70 right now, 70K. Yeah. So if you would have bought some about 3 months ago, you would have been up almost 20%.
See?
That's huge.
Yeah, big time.
Ooh. Yeah.
Big time.
Wow. Wow.
I need to get in too.
I found out about TikTok and my feelings was hurt. That's my favorite app, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, it's fire.
Social media platform.
It's fire. I ain't gonna lie to you.
It brought back dancing. You know, I love when we used to dance, and I guess we was in high school, middle school at that time. That's when everybody was really trying to go outside for real and dance. Nobody was really fighting too heavy.
Facts.
It was a time and place for that too. And you know, TikTok, in my opinion, brought it back. They put on a lot of artists, or we, the viewers. I don't know how you really want to word it, but you know, I feel like it was another platform for music to be heard again.
Mm-hmm.
And with it being gone now, I'm really curious to see what's going to take place next, right?
Correct.
How do you continue to market yourself? How do you continue to market your brand? I feel like this is just, it could be my opinion.
Yeah.
I feel like you make sure TikTok sees it first.
Nice.
And then you branch off to your Facebook, your Instagram, your Twitter, whatever else you got going on. That's just my opinion. What do you guys think?
I feel like also guerrilla marketing is not dead either. When I say guerrilla marketing, sometimes you got to get your name out in the streets too. Like them billboards, they got digital billboards. You got digital billboards. Even if the flyers don't work, because you know, you might leave a club, you might see a flyer in your car, you may or may not look at it, but I think we should take it to where, you know, you drive it, you're gonna look at a billboard. Well, who's that? I nobody, buddy on a digital billboard, right? And they got to now to where you ain't even got to be in that state. You just got whatever budget you got, you pay budget. It can be in New York, it can be in LA, it can be in Vegas, it can be in Houston,
it can be 30 seconds, 1 minute, 10 seconds,
exactly,
too.
Exactly, around the world. So that's another way of marketing yourself. I feel like, you know, adapting with the times. I say, like, every day with the music. You know how we went from the shoot 'em up, bang bang era, and, you know, the drill era? I think it's going back now to dedicating to the ladies. Mm-hmm. If you hear where the music's at right now, if you hear every artist coming out, like, example being, shout out to homie Honcho. Mm-hmm. Honcho got songs, but, like, Honcho was making real music, and people went, it went hitting to people, right? So once he switched it up to the ladies,
Skiller baby, that's right, yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? So it's getting to an era to where now it's kind of more empowering women. Rob 4-9, some of his songs, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
For the ladies, you dig what I'm saying?
Little ratchet, but you know.
But it's,
that's okay.
But she said, that's okay.
The lady said, it's okay, carry on.
So it's for the ladies. So I feel once again, like, everything changes. You got to learn to adapt to the change. That's why some of the greats, like the Jay-Z's, the Drake's, Rick Ross's, 50 Cent's, they still relevant because they adapt with the times.
Dapping with the times.
Real quick, we got a shout out to IG. We got OG Dino showing love.
Hey.
Shout out my boy Dino.
Simon Sound Studio showing love.
Shout out Simon Sound.
Definitely tapping in.
What's up, guys? man, I'm just so happy that it's Friday.
Man,
go in on that.
I know it's very random, but
you said you had a story. Just saying. But I now, now your face has changed. Save the story for the end. I love a good story, a great story. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Right, I'm here on the Midday Live Show, National Women's Day. If you want to say something, Jess, just say it.
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't want to say it.
There you go. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. We don't want to pry. Yeah.
Give me a minute. I'll see. Cause scary hours. Okay.
Oh, LOL. Like that.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Want to play rapid fire in the meantime?
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Let's change the subject. He switches it up.
Definitely. Definitely. Well, real quick, Young G, you are an OG,
man.
Here to the Midday Live Show, you know how the game is played. Yes, first sir. Thing that comes to your head, you want to let it go.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Now, I do know we had like we added some questions that were the Valentine's
Day. Yeah, ask the spicy ones.
Yeah, the Valentine's Day edition. Yeah, so, yeah. And I know with you and your release and whatnot, I think this would be perfect.
Yeah,
right?
Say less.
So I'm going to start off. I'm going to hit the first five questions, guys, and then we could rotate from there. All right, Young G, are you ready?
Man. Good as I'm ever going to be.
Young G, how do you deal with romantic attention or unwanted romantic attention?
Man, unwanted romantic attention, I'll just be like, you know, you cool. We friends. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate the love and support. God just, bless your heart.
Just talk
bless
it out.
Your heart.
God bless your heart.
Who's playing with the font? What's going on, Isaiah?
What are you doing?
I was trying to number them so I can see which one was the fifth one.
Just use your head.
Just follow along.
Yeah. Point. Count. You got this. Number two.
Yeah. Two.
How's your favorite? Or what's your favorite sitcom and crush from that show?
Oh, man. I ain't gonna lie. I said in a rap, I used to have a crush on Tisha Campbell, so I gotta go with Marty.
Gina.
Gina.
That's what's up. Ooh, he said that with emphasis.
And no hesitation. Gina was
tough.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was
tough, too. Yeah, Pam was pressure. I ain't gonna lie.
She was pressure for real.
Pam was pressure.
BB had that thing.
Come on.
What's wrong with this street sweeper?
Man, it looked like Marty wanted to cheat, but he couldn't. What? He had to stick to the script.
Yeah. The junk in the trunk.
Rewind. What did you say?
The street sweeper.
Sweeper.
You can't say sweeper.
No, sweeper.
Sweeper.
Yeah.
Okay. I've never heard of that. You can't say I'm familiar. Okay.
It's an OG time.
Oh, excuse me, youngin.
Oh, number three. Who's your current celebrity crush?
Mm-hmm. My current celebrity crush. I like SZA.
Ooh.
Mm. So
who doesn't?
Shout out to SZA
too, for sure.
What's up?
final question for me, then we'll pass it on. How would someone get your special attention?
Man, just if you like me, come holler at me. You dig what I'm saying? Like, if you just go for it. Just, you know,
and then,
if I like you, you know what I'm saying? But just go for it.
It's tough for a lady, I think. And in my old age, I've never really had too many women approach me. It's always been the other way.
She was gonna shoot. I said that earlier, right?
Oh, mm-hmm.
It's all really, like I said, you know, they say the guys are pursuers, but I feel like nowadays in this generation, people don't care. They like what they like, they want, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. Good point.
You gotta be in
shots, ladies. Stop liking his photos and actually slide in the DM.
Get up in there.
That's pretty much what he just said.
Get up in there.
I'm just gonna be here to tell y'all what he just said.
Stop being scurry. So, okay, yeah, I'll take over. So, would you date a fan?
You know what I'm saying? Honestly, I look at this as my profession. I keep a profession, but you know, they say love is love, attraction is attraction. So I just gotta say, you never know. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You never know, because the law of attraction is real. Mm-hmm. Some people say what they won't do, but end up doing it. So
real.
I believe in the law of attraction too. Mm-hmm. Definitely do.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's go with your artist name, Real Young G. Would you ever change it?
Honestly, if I would change something, no. I'll go by my real name, Greg. But Real Young G just means Real Young Greatness. It's just the acronym is short, because I believe that everybody's destined for greatness. So instead of being Young Greatness, I just say Real Young Greatness, because I feel like, you know what I'm saying, you only get one real shot in life to be great. That's what it means.
Put a little extra pizzazz on it.
Yeah.
Real. Okay. Biggest pet peeve?
Don't annoy me.
That just, how do you get annoyed?
Man, I get annoyed by just, you know, just taking me out of my zone, taking my focus. Peace of mind is everything. You lose your peace, you lose your sanity. So just don't let me lose my peace of mind. I could be every name in the book. You can, whatever the case may be, but peace of mind is everything. Because I feel like a person, if you ain't got peace, you ain't got nothing.
Yeah, I like that. Because, you know, you would want her to be your, you know, peace from the world. Because the world can be, you know, stressful, a little anxious. But you don't want none of those feelings when you go to your partner. You want to go to your partner, cozy up next to him, be like, hey, this is where it's at.
Real life.
Yeah.
Real life.
Your sanctuary. There we go.
Exactly. Aww. Exactly. Sweet. Okay. Well, since you were talking about being irritating, what is something annoying that you do? Do you have any annoying habits?
Yeah. Because, like, don't tell me never buy. Never buy. What you mean never buy? You better go and finish your thought. So
he doesn't like that.
Okay. What you mean never?
Yeah,
what you
mean never buy? Bring it up, right?
Like, come on. Like.
Say what you got to
say. Say how you feel about it. You know, you tough. Yeah. Say it with your chest out. Yeah. Let me know what's going on.
I feel that. Because
we can get out the way. Because then if I say, okay, whatever, and then a couple days later, so yeah, anyway, I was thinking, don't let it boil over. Let's get out open on the table, get it done. If we can come to agreement, cool. If we can't, still cool. But at least you said what you had to say. Don't make me think. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Real. Okay. I see why the real Young G, that's what the name is. And he said, two drinks with the fellas, that's a real response. LOL. There we go. Okay, last one for me. I'll pass it to DJ Spoiled Milk. Yeah. Worst date you've ever been on.
Ooh.
Do you have a story?
Man, I do have a story, actually. I was, you know what I'm saying? I'll probably say 18, 19, you know, taking this girl. I feel like I finally got a car, taking this girl out. And she was like, where you want to go? It don't matter. I'm like, okay, go to the movies. She picked the movie. I fell asleep in the movie. I ain't gonna lie to you.
What?
I fell asleep in the movie.
Uh-huh.
You dig what I'm saying? And she was one of them chicks to ask questions. Like, so what you think about it? I said, I ain't gonna lie to you. I was knocked out. She's like, take me home now. I said, for sure. The vibe wasn't vibing anyway.
That was crazy. He's like, for sure. Got you.
Less.
Uber X.
Let's go. First time my eyes didn't open up.
Oh my God.
LOL. Okay.
Sheesh. That's good stuff. Okay.
This is what makes it as good stuff.
Who is the messiest person you know?
Ooh.
Ooh.
As your lawyer, I advise that you do not give any names.
Bad.
Yeah.
But it was. It, mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's the name around? What's the name? You know.
Okay. I feel you.
Yeah.
I feel you because what's the name be tweaking?
Oh, bro.
Yeah. I don't like them either.
You ain't never lied.
Oh, bro.
Where would you like to travel the next vacation?
Tokyo.
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 You know what I'm saying? Be culture. I want to do something different. Yeah. You know, take it out the States. So.
That's nice. I'm like real heavy into cars and like the Fast and Furious. I live by that. That's like a Bible for me.
Yeah.
I really want to know, like, are they just really driving like that out there? Like, do they drift corners for real? Like, in the actual movie that they
portray? I really do.
I would love to see that if I was in Tokyo.
Oh, like, God.
I want to go to one of them little car meets for real.
I used to be a big gamer. I just want to go see how to make the games. And,
you know, me too. Yeah. Me too. I'm a little bit of a gamer too. But like, I hear they got like these video game districts where you just walk down and it's just straight like a video game world. Yeah, you're walking into.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know what to say there, but it's just incredible. Right?
Nice. All right. Let's see what else we got here. What else we got here? Who is your inspiration?
God. For sure, God.
Great answer.
Definitely God, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And then in a humanly form, I would like to say, you know, my parents, you know, they motivate me to always do better and always chase my dreams. They've been motivating me since I was a youngin', just to go ahead and go at it, go chase your dreams. You can do anything you want in this world, go chase your dreams. That does something as a kid, hearing that you can do anything in the world, chase your dreams. Because we live in a society where people are so doubtful and people are haters. They don't want to see you make it. So people want you at your level, want you at their level or below. So when you get a chance to be great, and somebody's motivating you to be great, you better go take that shot.
Oof.
Mm-hmm. I'm not asking no more questions after that.
That's a fadeaway. That is a fadeaway.
Okay, so you survived rapid fire, but we're not done with you yet.
Okay.
I say we take a little quick break because something interesting is coming.
Oh.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
We'll be back.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Now pop, now drop, now twerk, now work. Now come on, y'all, let's do, 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 let's do. Now shake, now bounce, now pop, now drop, now twerk.
Oh man.
Tragic.
Yeah.
Are we on?
Yeah, we're coming.
Yep.
Hello.
Hi guys.
Okay.
5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2.
Seconds I count with my sleep on fleek. Honey can spin on that patty for leap. Bitch, I'm a dog in my tree. Hop out the frog and leap. I put them bricks in the fender. My bitch, she walk around like she Chris Jenner. I used to break in the ammo.
5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 1.
Just like that.
When I move, you move.
Just like that.
Hell yeah, DJ, bring that back.
How you ain't gon' fuck? Bitch, I'm me. I'm the goddamn reason you in VIP. CEO, you don't have to CID. I'm young, wild, and strapped like...
Welcome back, everybody, to the Midday Live Show. Yes, and you hear the sound effects. I'm pouring myself a little glass of 1349 tequila. We're talking about the best tequila you ever had. And I just want to take a moment to thank the CEO and owner of Tequila 1349, Elizabeth Lopez.
Shout out to Lizzie, man.
Yes.
Yeah.
And no. Happy International Women's Day, yeah. Elizabeth. You're
Flex
amazing.
Flex your shirt. Boss. Don't you got like a shirt too? You got the Women's Empowerment shirt?
Yeah.
Flex the shirt. Don't forget.
It's smooth.
Empowered women, empower women is what my shirt says. Nice.
Now, we have a lot of listeners on Spotify, iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, etc., and Google Podcasts as well. So I want everyone to take a sip of this delicious Tequila 1349 Blanco Edition, and then I want to describe it to you with a few words.
Before we take a sip, man, we got to put one up in the air just for the women one more time.
Let's go for the ladies.
Cheers.
Shout out to my mom.
One time. Oh,
wife.
Yeah.
Shout out to my daughter. Shout out to my auntie.
That's right.
All, my
all of them.
Shout out to Jazz.
Big shout out to Jazz.
Thank you.
Much love.
Big shout out.
Happy Women's Day.
Happy Women's Day, everybody.
Ooh, that's liquor.
No, but that's smooth, though. That's
no, that's real smooth.
Smooth. It's very smooth.
Like, you know, you know, some tequila you drink.
Yeah.
Then you just like.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No, I don't even need
it
to taste
it. It just goes.
Nice, yeah, and it just goes,
smooth.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Make you feel warm. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Now, if you can, please close your eyes and imagine yourself on the vibrant streets of Chicago.
The,
where passion and flavor intertwine.
The what?
Where?
The vibrant? Is that what you said?
Yeah, the vibrant streets of Chicago. Okay. Where passion and flavor intertwine in every sip. Introducing Tequila 1349, the epitome of sophistication and allure. So that's all it is. We want everybody to indulge in the allure of Tequila 1349.
Yeah.
Elevate every moment with exquisite taste. Nice. Get yourself a bottle today at Benny's everywhere.
Nice.
Tell them the Midday Live Show sent you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right, they're gonna end up sending us the bill. Invoice.
Wrong answer.
Well, thank you again, guys, for joining. Hit the subscribe button if you want to get a notification every time we release a new video every week. And on top of that, we're dishing out clips on the Instagram at the Midday Live Show.
Yeah.
Don't forget to follow.
Okay, so before I get into the story, I need to loosen myself up a little bit. Do you remember the game we played, Bustin' or Disgusting?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Love that game.
We love that game here.
We love it.
So I'm gonna pull up the first image. What do we got here?
Can you pass that over there?
Right. See.
So Jasmine scours the internet for amazing cuisine. And this is what she found today. What? Is this a...
This is real too.
Yeah, Maris just tried it, right?
Yeah.
I saw the video.
This is real?
It's
this
real.
This is real, real. Real Young G real.
So it's real Young G real.
So this is a chicken patty. Okay. Is it a chicken patty?
Yeah.
Chicken patty with, it looks like cheese and pepperoni. It might be a little piece of sauce.
A little bit.
It might be a little piece of sauce.
Yeah, there's a little piece of sauce, a little marinara, maybe. A little red sauce.
A cheese.
It's mozzarella cheese for sure.
Yeah.
A cheese.
How we feeling about that? And feel free to comment. You watching along. Is it bussing or is it disgusting?
Man, if I'm high, it's bussing.
Right?
For sure.
Wasn't there a part in the Goofy movie where he's like the Leaning Tower of Cheesa?
Yes. Yeah.
That's what
I'm on to you, KFC.
KFC.
I am on to y'all.
See what I'm saying? Kentucky Fried. crooks.
Mm.
Oh, I like how you put that. I like how you put that.
Watch them come after me.
Right. I'm like, this video is now blocked. 22. Right?
Watch me unblock it.
I did not know that KFC low-key had a little bit of heat. Like, I've always been... My family, my household, we go to Popeyes. We order live and die by Popeyes.
Live and die by Popeyes.
Popeyes chicken at my funeral.
Okay.
Repass.
Wow.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of chicken in there.
Next to the meatballs.
Yeah, all that. But KFC low-key got some heat. They have a chicken sandwich. So you know how we had that huge trended thing, who has the better chicken sandwich? Mm-hmm. We forgot about KFC, and I'm just gonna put that out there. On your own time, check it out.
I guess. So, I disagree. The sandwiches are good. I like the little chicken littles.
I don't know nothing about
that. Was that like the snack?
The snack size.
Those are good.
Those are delicious. Yeah, the chicken littles. You can get like honey hot. So good. Mm. Or so hot honey.
With the knowledge that I have about their chicken sandwich, I'm going to say this is busted. Mm. And I don't have to be high. I can be sober. A definite munchie though, like
for sure.
For sure, that's what they did. It was one day at KFC headquarters in we'll say Arkansas. Somebody slipped, fell, landed in a pile of amazing. Because I'm gonna say it's bussin'. I want to try it, even though I'm lactose intolerant. I'm in. Mm. I'm in.
I keep forgetting that about you.
I love pizza, but I'll take a risk. I'll take a gamble. Yeah. I'll risk it for the biscuit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it's busting too. Yeah.
It's incredible.
I would try it for sure.
Are they selling this in stores right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sheesh. Might have to take a long way to the crib.
To the Walmart. You dig what I'm saying?
Disclaimer, we are not being sponsored. We are not sponsored. This is not paid ad.
Get off on
Walmart. Oh, God. Oh, God. You understand what I'm talking about? Yeah.
Yeah. I love it. But we can smile and nod. It's different. We're smiling now. It's different.
Somebody from the Burbs in here, y'all start acting different.
Different.
I'm on the island, bro. They always Chicago this, Chicago that. I love Chicago.
For sure.
But you know,
the time with it.
A little bit of energy in here today. Y'all be just be acting.
Keep the energy. Keep the energy.
But with all that,
it'd be a little different.
Oh, two drinks with the fellas. He tried it. He said the picture is better than the real thing.
No, don't say that to me. It's like the book is better than the movie.
Ruin it.
Ruin it. Tough. Might have to be hiding it, huh?
Yeah.
That's in my hair.
Did nothing to it today, and that's going up.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Steve Styles check.
All I have looking with a mini flat top over here.
Okay. Okay. Shout out to the hair. Period.
Wild.
Next one. We got... Tuna Loops. This is from Leisure Suit Linda herself.
No, you...
Wait.
Linda, this is a show for the children.
No, she found it. She found it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Clarification. Hey,
automatically. Automatically disgusting. Yeah. Just look at that, boy. Ooh, not even on the high day.
That's a ghetto meal for real. I feel like we're just throwing everything that we find in the kitchen.
What makes you want to put that together?
Put the kids to bed.
Yeah. Tuna. Ain't nobody sitting on that.
Put some melatonin in it.
Right. Right.
Yeah. You just reminded me of that video. It was like, ugh. Y'all seen that? Brother, ugh. What's that, brother?
Oh my gosh. It's just, it's unnecessary. That's all it is. Unnecessary roughness on the play.
I'm cool on it.
Yep. Gotta go disgusting.
Hot. What? I'm just shocked. Now I'm curious. What would make you do that?
That's what I said. Like,
that's incredible.
Where's the mindset? Are we okay? Do we need to like do a mental health check-in?
Yeah, please.
I think
this
so.
This person right here was broke, and they get paid in 3 days. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah. That's what they chose to mix together.
Or you know, this person could have been like, Shorty could have been like, "Do you cook?" Hell yeah, baby, I cook. Say y'all was going down right now, man. Stop playing.
Yeah, I'm gonna fix you a plate.
This is my go-to,
man. Right now, as we speak, you dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, you gonna be ready to marry me after this
one. Oh man,
y'all heard of marry me chicken, marry me tuna loops?
Then it goes. She'll be like, "What is this, man? E for effort."
You get nothing from that meal.
What you talking about?
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
I left my phone in the car. I'll be right there.
Yeah. I love that one. Well, your phone right there. Shh, my other phone. You got two phones. And it keeps going. Young G, you too smooth.
man.
Chill. You too smooth out here.
Smooth.
Gotta watch out for him. He's out here with an answer.
Voice in there, dude, got real deep.
Mm-hmm. Said, yeah, that's what's yeah. Both of y'all voices are so deep. I can never like.
We have moments when
try
it drops.
To impersonate it.
Yeah.
She said, "I can never impersonate."
Steve hit you with the. Now close your eyes.
Right. Right.
This tequila. Man.
Like, what? What are you doing? Oh.
Somebody get his man an endorsement.
Oh my gosh.
Now close your eyes.
Imagine so, an island.
Picture drinking this in the island. Cabo Wabo.
We call it sex on the beach,
right?
Did I say Cabo Wabo?
Yeah.
What? I don't know. When I heard you sing, I was starting to think of like that Boyz II Men. It's like, close your eyes, make a wish.
Nah, you need to go holler at Allstate for real. He ain't gonna stay alive too long.
Yeah, exactly. I tell everybody, you in good hands. You in good hands.
Sooner or later, it's gonna be time for him to transition.
Uh-huh.
You're gonna take that position. Okay.
Real talk.
All you do is rap today, bro. Everything's rhyming that's coming out of your mouth. How do you do that?
You got a whispers in the dark voice.
Whispers in the dark.
The fella says. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. That's what's up.
Okay.
Quick shout out. I want to show everybody the jersey I got.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Game time.
Do it.
All right. There we go. Here we go. There you go. There you go. Number one. It's crazy,
hey,
man.
That's
the detail.
Heavy, right? I ain't gonna lie to you.
I like it, man. So much. See how it got in there too, and the
ooh,
mess around.
Yeah, that's heavy.
That's hard. That's
thinking
fire.
We could, you know, talk to Chime and sell some spots real quick, like they do, you know, in the NBA and soccer.
And wait, real quick, where are you wearing that?
I'm wearing this tomorrow at Morgan Park Academy, the gymnasium.
What's going on at Morgan Park Academy?
I'll be playing in the 312 Celebrity Music Awards basketball
nice.
Game.
He
will be in attendance.
He'll be in attendance. If you need some tickets, holla at me today because we're giving away the last, what is it? It's going to be 12 tickets left. 12 tickets left to give away. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Let us know. Yeah, come on it. By. If you're out there, that's all. Represent the city and have a good time.
Man,
there's going to be some giveaways. There's going to have some food. Mm-hmm. Going to have some live performances. Like a few artists are going to be rapping and singing and whatnot. So plus, we got DJ Lil Jon.
Yes.
You know?
Stop it.
But it's going to be up and it's going to be stuck. And I can't wait till tomorrow. Then Sunday, catch us at 312 Music Awards.
Yes.
We'll be there this Sunday.
Yes, sir.
Busy sure weekend.
Because I'm winning something.
You are. We're saying
I'm
that.
Winning something. I'm winning DJ of the Year on Sunday.
Yes, sir. Yes, you are.
You heard it here first.
Like Kanye.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah.
If I don't win, I'll go on stage like Kanye.
Do that, actually.
Why not? But yeah. One second, please. Let me see the mic real quick.
Mm-hmm. Midday had the best show podcast of the game.
Okay.
In the game, you heard.
Yeah.
Say it again. Mm-hmm. Okay. Last Bustin' or Discussin', then we're going to get to this story.
Ooh.
Okay, this is a mac and cheese chocolate chip cookie.
What the hell?
Is it busting or disgusting?
Man, that's disgusting, man. Who put cheese on chocolate chip?
That's a good point, man. I'm just not feeling it.
That's a lot of diarrhea. Pause.
Y'all might be mad at me. I ain't gonna lie to you.
What?
I have to at least try this.
Why?
Ooh. I love macaroni.
Mm-hmm.
Curiosity killed the cat, bro.
I rock with cookies too.
I rock with cookies.
Especially the hot chocolate chip cookies.
It would got to be warm and boneless.
It's got
to. When it got a little to it, you know what I'm talking about?
Okay,
it's not like firm in the
pop,
oven.
Lock,
it's
and
a little.
It. You gotta hit you with the
Don't you know something about cookies? Chocolate chip cookies?
Oh, yeah.
You have snacks.
I got snacks. I got YGN snacks coming up. We didn't.
I saw that.
We parted up. You know what I'm saying? My man's. We got YGN snacks. So we got different cookies. We got. Double chocolate chip, and caramel. So we working, nice. Man.
Where can we order?
It's Lincoln. You know what I'm saying? You can order off my website or off of Instagram. I have the link in the bio. Or Facebook, Twitter. I always post a link every day. I post a link. So just click the link. Y'all can go ahead and take some of the YGN snacks, man.
Yeah, get in try it out.
I did not know that.
Hey, come on, man.
So
Wayne the first to do it.
Come on now.
So would you add this cookie to your line?
Man, I ain't gonna lie to you. Hell no. But you know what I'm saying, man? It teaches all you, man.
What if this is a whole entire demo like that you can tap into right now? Clearly, somebody likes this cookie.
Somebody.
And you know, and depending on the demographic and if it makes dollars, then you guess what? Hell yeah, you get into YGN snacks.
Yeah. I gotta try it. I gotta see what's to it.
I'm good.
Has anyone ever had you got Thanksgiving, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
They really like, you kind of short on plates. You got one plate to make it happen. Okay. And don't throw it away. Just
right,
clean it off.
Right. Right.
Go back.
Okay. Get a little scrape.
I got it. Yeah. Okay?
Bring it back.
Yeah.
Somehow, in between spoons and different pans that you saw, your macaroni is touching your sweet potatoes. That's fire to me. If you ask,
it is.
I agree.
I agree.
Because
you
know,
you got a little sweet, got a little not savory, but a little salty. You know what I'm saying? What if this is?
It's
the same
different
energy?
Though. The sweet.
Yeah,
this,
it's not the same
that's
energy.
Sweet from a sweet potato. This sweet from milk.
What's wrong with it?
I don't know. It's probably worse if it's milk chocolate or dark chocolate or some chocolate, no chocolate.
No, this sounds nasty.
Yeah, bro. This is two thumbs down.
You need an intervention.
Or he's just hungry all the time.
Maybe,
I don't know.
Maybe.
I gotta try it. This, if I had to give you a bust or discuss it, I'm gonna say bust.
You know, I was eating weird shit when my son was about, you know, under 12 months.
Oh,
so maybe that could be it too. That could be it too.
This looks low key fire.
No, it does not.
I wonder if that person pulled the cookie off and the cheese was hitting
the little thing with the.
Come on.
Gross.
Bro.
With the chocolate chip at the same time?
Yeah.
It's making no sense.
Yeah.
You're thinking about it. Oh, my goodness.
Make it.
He's daydreaming.
Make
I'm
it.
Not making it.
Oh, okay.
Like the baked beans with the donut. I'm still waiting on the donut, my man, with the baked beans.
We're gonna be waiting forever.
Baked
forever.
Beans.
I'm gonna reach out to somebody. We're gonna plug a chef.
It's real easy. You get a donut, you get some beans, go to Aldi.
We're gonna plug a chef or a baker to make either the donut or this cookie. And if they can successfully do that,
yeah,
they're a goat. Okay.
And you're gonna try it.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I got somebody in mind right now.
Oh, okay. All right.
Great.
That's a different
great
way to say okay.
I ain't mad at you.
I'll try it.
Excellent. And Jazz, you know this is all Bussin' or Discussin'. You can get more information about Bussin' Discussin' on our YouTube channel.
Hello.
The Midday Live Show on YouTube.
Yeah.
Nice and simple.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys.
Story time.
Yep.
Hmm.
Okay. So they already know this backstory, but I'm going to reiterate it in a smaller version for you. So our company has a Christmas party every year, right? So that's always fun, you know.
Yeah.
Whatever. So we did a little after party, the bar across the street, right?
Oh,
me and Steve were both there. And we were there with some of our coworkers.
I was assaulted that night. That was the night that homeboy whispered in my ear.
No, that was a different night. That was a different night. I
thought it was the Christmas party. I'm having flashbacks.
Gosh.
Trauma.
That was the
trauma.
No, he did. I remember that.
Yeah.
What?
Save that.
Trauma.
That was the 2022 one. I'm talking about the most recent one.
Oh, yeah. That's he did not good.
Yeah. So I'm just regularly having a conversation with my coworker, right? We're talking about life, we're talking about work. And then he's like, you want to get out of here?
Oh, I'm like, cringe.
What do you mean?
We were just talking about your career and
like, how where did that come from? Right. So, he's like, yeah, that's my place. And I'm like,
what?
Mm-mm.
We're in the industry of transitions. There was no flow.
Wow.
It was just real choppy.
It came out of completely nowhere.
Right.
Yeah. No is right, girl. I was like, what are you talking about?
Right.
So, yeah,
I was like,
no, that's OK. So he sees me, you know, later that week and he's like, I'm so sorry. You know, my bad. Like, I didn't know you were in a relationship, whatever. And I'm like, OK, that's fine.
Moving on.
I got you. Moving on.
Moving
right
on.
So when was this? This week. I'm not going to be specific. This week, there is an event here that he needed my help with. So, So I go to help him and he's like, what does your boyfriend do?
Oh, no.
He,
so my mind immediately is like, what?
He's fishing.
I say what he does. And he's like, oh, okay. You doing anything fun this weekend? And I was like, the Taking Up Space event I mentioned Sunday.
Yeah.
312 Music Awards. Mentioned that to you. And he was like, oh, cool. What are you doing tonight?
Bold.
Whoa.
He's sober this time.
Completely.
Maybe.
At least I think so.
We don't know. We don't know. Some people identify as a beer can. You know, we don't know.
Right.
A beer can. So I'm like, going home, basically. And he was just like, well, this is over at so-and-so time. So if you're still around, like, hit me up and we could grab a bite. And I'm like, huh?
You don't. He must have forgotten. He's got that quarterback memory. Just forget the last play. Forget the last play.
But what's crazy is he started the conversation off with the boyfriend and what he does. So it was on his head, and that's how the conversation started. And then he decided to go past that and say,
all in the same breath,
F buddy, what you doing?
Yeah. Yeah. So
how does that, how?
How?
Hey, man, I told you before, Jazz, you a hot commodity, bro.
I understand that.
You are her.
This is good. Thanks. This is good.
You are her. At the same time, come on.
Yeah.
That how are you going to ask me about my boyfriend and then what I'm doing tonight in the same breath?
That's tough.
That's bold.
That's plotting. That's thinking and planning. What
I
say earlier,
shooters got to shoot.
Yeah.
I respect it. You but did? I don't like it.
Yeah, I would not respect it. But God, shut up.
And it's like, the thing is, I just be like, I'm, y'all know me, I'm a nice person.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, I'm not going to be like, oh my God. Like, yeah.
Oh.
But as you know, I'm just
smooth operator,
this.
What?
Come on.
It take, we get 1,000 no's, but take that one time.
Mm.
It take that one time. I'm trying to tell you. I know how to play. Listen, Steve Urkel got Laura.
He did. Come
he
on.
Did. You know what I'm saying? He did.
Steve.
He did.
He did.
Steve got Laura. It took that man since he grew up. You dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It take that one time. Look. We're going to conversate. We're going to talk. Okay, cool. Guess what? I might fall back for a minute. I might take a step back. One, two, backpedal. But guess what? When I see a little friction, if I see you having a bad day, I'm going to scoot it.
Wow. Yeah,
slide in there.
That's what it's giving, though.
So he's
like, I'm not giving up.
What about Myra, bro? What about Myra?
Man, Myra was a vibe. Myra was a placeholder.
Oh, Myra was there for him.
She was
all about Steve.
But see, Steve already had the heart. He already knew what he wanted. He was buying his time. We are human.
Ooh.
He was buying his time to get what he wanted. When he got what he wanted, he got it on lock.
Basically, what he just said here is
P101.
The man may not go away. Okay.
Yep.
Be forewarned.
So you may have to get real with your stiff arm game.
You
might have to get real with the
okay.
The niceness is not allowed. You know, he's not seeing past the nice letdowns.
Because
that's what I'm saying. I can't even be myself.
That's horrible. Leave me alone. I don't like your ugly ass. And he's gonna leave you alone. I promise you. He'll leave you alone after that.
Wow. Okay.
And let's
just take one time. One time. Keep that in the back of your head. The number one. You can say no. Something happened between you and your boyfriend. Hey, so how you feeling today? I'm down. Hey, wanna grab a bite to eat? Vulnerability.
Oh.
Vulnerability.
And then if he does shoot another shot, I think you have to be like really bold and say,
we got HR.
Boyfriend.
You know what I'm saying?
Is HR. This is at the workplace.
This is a work environment. Just saying that much.
With the boyfriend card too. And
just
say,
be mindful, man. Time and place.
Call my man and we can have this conversation together. You said you wanted to take both of us out to eat because he likes shrimp. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you can do that way.
For
too.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah.
Or he could be what if he says, like, hey, want to go get something to eat? But yeah, let's bring HR with us too.
Damn.
Yeah, I like my job more. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie to you.
That was scary. Whew.
Yeah.
I like my job.
Or you can go with him and just order double everything.
Careful.
Everything home.
Yeah, this ain't Cheesecake Factory.
Yeah. He might pay for it.
Cheesecakes,
too.
I need two air.
He will.
I'll be good when you get home.
And then he'll be like, see, that's all you need. You know what I'm saying? Listen, I'm trying to tell you, the opportunity presents itself. He jumping, he taking it.
Ooh, I see.
One time. Remember that number? Number one. I just need one time. Out of how is it? 365 days out of the year?
Yep.
I just need one of them.
Mm. LOL.
Steve Urkel, that was a beautiful metaphor right there.
Yeah, yeah. That was great. Wow. Wasn't expecting
incredible.
That.
Incredible.
Wow.
You got us? Okay. Hey.
Big shout out to the Instagram listeners and watchers checking us out on Instagram Live, YouTube, and Facebook Live.
Red flag. Oh, he bold.
Girl, bold is not the word. Bold is not the word.
An understatement.
Yeah, an understatement. I think that's a better way. Because I've encountered like a lot of interaction. You know what I'm saying? But like never one that bold. Yeah, and then not just one time. Twice.
Incredible.
I feel like the first time, you know, okay, you were lit. All right.
But
this man was
there's a reason
sober the next time.
I think. I would have to say so, yeah.
Then that means he meant everything he said the first time.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, there's a saying, a drunk man don't tell no lies.
Ooh.
But also too, you know, you get that liquid courage, you start jumping out your body.
Right,
so that's why you get like, you know, what am I looking for? Benefit of the doubt, right?
The first time.
That's why, yeah, I was like,
the
okay,
only time.
You know,
but yeah.
The second time, this time.
Now you know, like, all right, I gotta get disrespectful with him real quick. So he's
I hate that for me.
And then we move on.
We all have our non-negotiables, you know, and that could be something, a big theme from today, you know, stand your ground, have your morals, have your values, and have your non-negotiables.
Thanks.
You know.
Y'all making me be mean on Women's Day.
No, you're not being mean.
You gotta be mean. You
gotta
be mean. Just gotta stand on business.
That's all.
Yep.
That's
yep,
it.
Looks
That's
like
all.
It. Looks like it.
There we go, guys. It was a great episode. We want to thank you for joining us.
I appreciate y'all for having me.
Yeah.
I appreciate you. I come back here every time, man. It's a family hangout.
That's what it is. It's family.
Absolutely.
Having a great night.
And you know how I'm about to end it? With Jazz's joke of the day.
Of the day.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so one of my first jobs was working at a candy store. And you know what? I was like, I am really sick of this job. So you know what I said when I left out? Yeah. See ya, suckers.
Oh, makes sense. Makes sense.
This is the candy store. Yeah, you got suckers in the candy store. Yeah. Sucker in the Flint, the lollipops. I get it.
Thank you for the explanation.
Thank you. Thank
Appreciate
you for
that for the listeners out there. Yes.
Yeah. Full recap of 312 Music Awards next week.
Next week.
Yep. Max. And I'm assuming he'll have a trophy with him.
Ooh, even better. Good to
Come
hear.
Come on. I need it.
Manifested. Okay.
I need it.
It's coming. It's coming. Real Young G, one more time. Drop the socials.
Man, you can follow me at Real Young G. That's R-E-A-L-Y-U-N-G-G on TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, Apple Music, Spotify, SoundCloud, hell, even Google.
That's right.
Lock
good
in
SEO.
With me. Got YGN Snacks, YGN the label, the brand, and it's taking things to new heights. And you can do anything you want to do in this world. Don't let nobody tell you can't. That's what YGN.
That's right.
Period. You can follow me at Jazz or So Fierce. I'm on Kiss this weekend, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And I'll be at Taking Up Space, our women's event on Sunday, and 312 Music Awards later
nice.
That day.
Nice.
Excellent.
Nice. Oh, I think I'm going to be outside tonight in the town.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what's up? Where?
Sean Kingston low-key coming to the Forge.
Oh, yeah. I heard about that. Yeah.
Sean Kingston.
Girls all
beautiful.
Yeah. It's OG.
So
at the
I think I'm going to slide, see what's to it. You know what I'm saying? Get out the house. Saturday, we are at the 312 Music Award basketball game. Got to see my boy Steve go
Thank
crazy.
Thank you so
He's
much for the support.
With that jersey.
It's going to be crazy.
He's going to
be crazy.
All right.
Going for 50.
Going for 50. I'm going to shoot. I'm going to take 50 shots. We'll see what lands, what goes in. All right.
You're going for 50, okay?
Right.
MVP. Saturday. Oh, and I also got that brunch, too.
But Big I think brunch. It's Big know. Brunch.
I think it's a private brunch.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to get a little toasty, right? And then make my way to the basketball game on Saturday.
Period.
Excellent. Yeah. Love to hear that.
Yeah.
And don't forget to follow him too, DJ Spoiled Milk on all platforms.
There you go.
The nastiest DJ in Chicago. Ooh. What's that smell?
Ooh.
Ooh, boy. I'm Steve Styles, you know, the master podcaster. I feel like I've been doing this for 1,100 years.
Yeah.
That's even a real number. Check me out.
It is today.
This weekend, the basketball game. If you need tickets, holler at me in the DMs. I know there's a few people I'm going to reach out to today to send you your tickets. And along with that, too, have an amazing weekend. It's beautiful out there. Psych.
And I was like, no, it's not.
It's raining like a mug out there, man. I hate the rain.
Oh, also, too, check out the podcast episode with myself and Two Drinks with the Fellas.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
That's dropped today. Check it out, man. We talk about top female artists in the game, rappers, go-to songs, all that. So
nice.
Great to hear.
Love it.
Check that out as well.
Two Drinks with the Fellas. That's on YouTube. It's right there. So make sure y'all check it out.
Yes, sir.
I guess we're over and out of here for today.
Let's get to it, guys. Thank you for joining us.
Peace, and we out.